I'm here as a reminder to tell you that Jesus is the Good Shepherd. And what do I mean by that? We're reading from John 10:10 from the NET, and it says, "The thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. I have come so that they may have life and may have it abundantly." This verse is so cool, and it just resonates with me so much. This is where Jesus is obviously talking about himself as being the Good Shepherd. And in contrast with this thief that only comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And for me, what I really took out of that was, a thief is this person who has their best interests at heart, who wants to do things only to benefit themselves. Where the Good Shepherd, where Jesus comes to give us life and give it abundantly, it's this other's focus, this intentional sacrifice, this effort to lead others who go astray, to actually give them this life, to give and to show them the way to a better place. And I'm not just talking about heaven. I'm talking about the way that we live, the way that we act, the way that we think, most importantly. And what this verse is telling us is that Jesus is this person who wants us to live a life that is not with a scarcity mindset, with this mindset where we believe that there isn't enough, but that we actually walk around thinking and knowing and believing that there is more than enough of anything and everything, that we could live a life others focused because all of our needs will be met in Jesus. And then he goes on to talk about him being the only way to that. Because if we think about it, if we try and live any other way other than Jesus, there is always this selfish desire that comes with it. And the funny thing is, all of that often only shows way later down in the track. And so for us, when we actually focus on Jesus, when we get to actually participate in his plan and his purpose for us, we actually both live the best life we can, but also help all the people around us. And so can I encourage you, when you see a thief, or when you see a person who has their best interests at heart, do not listen to them, or at least put Jesus' words first, because he came so that you may have life and have it abundantly. And so please, if you have time and a space and a place to do so, spend time with Jesus. Ask him anything, and he will be able to open your eyes and show you where you need to go or who you need to talk to. And if you really have no one, us as youth leaders, we are always here and ready to talk and walk with you. I hope you guys have a good rest of the day. Bye.